Is a big girl.
Good. All right, let's talk to Kelly in East Brunswick. You're on New Jersey 101.5. Hi, Kelly.
Hi.
Hi.
So I was just listening, and I just found myself kind of getting frustrated because you were talking about how girls are dressing more provocatively in this day and age, and like the way we act and stuff. And I was kind of a little bit insulted by that.
Are you in college?
Yeah, I am in college.
Okay, that's now I know why you're insulted. Continue.
Well, I'm also insulted because I'm a girl who has dealt with male teachers trying to make a move just because I'm a girl and just because, you know, I dress a certain way. And you have to understand it's a two-way street. And I'm actually kind of proud of this Stephanie situation or whatever. I didn't even know it existed. Because I feel like someone needs to make a difference here. Like, there needs to be a stand taken here. And I was just really upset by the whole, oh, girls dress provocatively and they're objectively dressed.
But if you dress, it is a two-way street. That's exactly the point we're trying to make. And that is that if you don't want a man to look at you, then you shouldn't wear things that are revealing. And if you are wearing something revealing, a man's going to look. You get that.
Look at you in a certain way.
Yeah. You get that, right?
Yeah, that's fine. Doesn't mean you should be hopping all over me.
No, and it's certainly, there certainly is not the that phrase or that, I wouldn't have said that in the context of being attacked or raped or fondled inappropriately or unwarranted. I'm just saying in the course of girls talking to young men who are teachers, if you dress and act provocatively, many of them are weak enough to take the bait. If it's an attack, there's no excuse for anybody to attack anyone because of how they're dressed or come
on. We're not talking about attack. Who is talking about attack? We're talking about having an affair with a teacher and how difficult it is for a man to resist that urge. Way more difficult it is for a woman. You understand that it's different.
Yeah. Teaching young girls.
Maybe not.
He can't resist himself.
Yeah. Have a good day. I don't know what else to say. It's so hard to speak to your...
I just thought maybe
young,
I could...
inexperienced mind when it comes to this. You're looking to get offended by something. I got that. So you made the call. So hopefully you understand I'm not talking about in the case
I'm
of...
I'm not looking to get offended
yes,
by
you are. Okay, hold on. Let me finish my sentence. So I'm not talking about how girls dress when they are attacked or an unprovoked advance is made. I'm talking about in talking to a teacher, dressed provocatively, talking in a provocative way. He's a man, and as much he's supposed to be responsible and well-behaved, some of them may cave into those sort of desires they have inside them. This has certainly nothing to do with any unprovoked attack or fondling. Okay, do you understand that part?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nobody was defending, God forbid, rape or attack.
Or someone unwanted advances.
It's get the difference between a male and a female when it comes to sexual attraction.
She doesn't. She doesn't. Say that again. Ask her that again.
Explain to me the difference between a male and a female when it comes to attraction to the opposite sex.
Okay, girls aren't looking for guys to dress with short skirts and looking for them to be walking around shirtless. Girls are more attracted to mine when guys are more attracted to physical appearance.
Okay, that's
very good.
She does get it.
Thank you.
College did not destroy your mind yet.
So then you would also say it's a two-way street, and if a woman is going to dress in a provocative way in the middle of a college classroom, then she has to understand a man's going to be attracted. Would you at least admit that a man is going to be attracted to you?
I'm not going to say they're not going to be attracted, but I'm saying they shouldn't, you know, go for it just because she's acting a certain way, because she's still a teacher.
Yeah, we would never say that. Yeah. So then you misunderstood us. So then you misunderstood us because we would never justify it. Never.
Okay.
But the idea of your saying, you misunderstood. And the idea that what leads me to believe that you didn't understand is because you said then they shouldn't be teaching young girls, because that's ridiculous. Obviously, a man, just because he's attracted to young, attractive women, that should not preclude him from being a teacher.
Well, I'll tell you what, if I were teaching young girls in high school or college, I would never be alone with them, and I would never put myself in a situation to have them approach.
Yeah, that's the point.
Never. Because
men are animals.
Yeah. We run on an animal instinct that you rely on in relationships once you have a consensual relationship, which you might understand down the road. But anyway, Kelly, thank you so much for chiming in today. What are you studying?
I'm an education major, actually.
Very good.
That's
good luck to you.